Hi, everybody. Meteorologist Joe Cioffi here. Weather in five days and 5 minutes as we look at the satellite loop. One of the things we're watching today is this little blob that came out of southeastern Missouri of showers and thunderstorms. It's a little shortwave trough that is moving along, and those thunderstorms pretty much held together overnight and still moving their way to the northeast. And this is why the Storm Prediction Center has put up an area of risk for today. That risk area has now actually been expanded a bit further to the east. And in fact, at least as of 11:30, they are, Storm Prediction Center, indicating that for South Central, actually for all of Central Pennsylvania, indicating that a severe thunderstorm watch is likely to go up later today. And we'll wait and see whether that gets pushed a little bit further to the east. There it is on the radar. And you can see here a couple of warnings that went up. Now, remember, if you're watching this on a replay, you're watching a dated radar and a dated satellite. So be sure to go to weather.gov to get all the latest information regarding severe weather in your particular area. A few echoes showing up. Moving northeastward, running ahead of it. Much of that isn't reaching the ground, but we're going to be watching this very, very closely. And this is one of the reasons why the temperatures were actually taken down a little bit for today. Not so much along the coast, because we knew we were going to have a southeast wind, and that's exactly what we have. And highs are going to be in the upper 60s and low 70s from coastal New Jersey to Long Island and southern New England, the southern New England coast into southeastern New England. But you head inland, and then, of course, it gets much warmer. Temperatures up in the low and mid 80s in parts of northeastern Connecticut to Massachusetts. And then you go to the south from mainly south of Route 78 down through interior southern New Jersey, southeast and south central Pennsylvania. There's where we see middle and even upper 80s and a few 90 degree readings showing up in the Washington, D.C., Baltimore area. We're still on course for tomorrow being a very hot day. Temperatures are going to reach up into the low and middle 90s. Even along the coast, temperatures will probably make a run at least for the 80s, and some of the areas just slightly inland of the coast, like the North Shore of Long Island or just inland of the Jersey Shore, you'll probably see temperatures up around 90 with the wind turning more to the southwest, which is a much more favorable wind. And you'll notice, too, 90s all the way up into New England, almost into Maine. And you've got middle 90s around the Washington, D.C., Baltimore area down into Virginia. So a very hot day setting up for Saturday. We've got another hot day setting up for Sunday with a cold front approaching. Highs will be a little lower, though, upper 80s and lower 90s. And we have the chance that there could be some severe weather risk on Sunday. The Storm Prediction Center has marginal risk down in northeast Virginia. Then northeastward from there, and then it turns into a slight risk as you move through upstate New York and on up into New England. As far as rainfall is concerned over the next week, big rains in the lower Mississippi Valley back into Texas, and then northeastward into and toward the lower Great Lakes of 2 or more inches, and in some places 3 or more inches. Here in the northeast and northern mid-Atlantic states, it's mostly about anywhere from a half to as much as an inch or an inch and a quarter. And of course, it's convective, so a lot of this is going to depend on thunderstorm activity. So we looked at the European last night. The models are still a little different going forward in the longer term. In the shorter term, they're about the same. You can see that little kink there. This is what we're watching for late this afternoon, is this right there. That is what came out of southeastern Missouri from last night and continues to move to the northeast, and it's just that little trough. That's what we're going to be watching going into this evening. Then the ridge builds over the weekend. We get into our heat. The next trough swings well to the north and west, tries to push a cold front through Sunday night, gets hung up slightly until the ridge can flatten, and then it'll just drop southward. And as we go through next week, the next trough of importance and cold front with this will probably come on Friday with some showers and thunderstorms going into the Memorial Day holiday weekend. And this is where the models differ a bit. The GFS has a slightly less rosier outlook for the Memorial Day weekend. The European builds a big ridge along the East Coast and would suggest that we would probably see a warm and mostly dry Memorial Day holiday weekend. It's certainly better than what we had from last year. So as far as the rest of today goes, there's that little blob there. You see it right there, that little blob moving northeastward, clipping a few places. Tomorrow and Sunday, it's sunny and hot. Cold front for Sunday night with some showers and thunderstorms. I think they stay away until after sunset, and then they may start to, they will fall apart after that. Some drier air comes in for Monday and Tuesday and cooler air, and then we set up for the end of next week. And I'm buying the idea that it'll just be a cold front with some showers and thunderstorms coming through along about Friday. And then for the Memorial Day weekend, again, this is an early look. If we believe the European, it'll be a nice and more than likely a warm weekend. So keep a watchful eye on that area of thunderstorms moving eastward for later this afternoon and this evening. We'll see if it holds together. And otherwise, have a great weekend. The Joe and Joe Show will be back on Sunday at 11 a.m. Eastern Time.